Hello everyone, this is Somanes for the next CODM2 review, the one of Copperic. So let's go. There is a contest as a description. We will play with a quarter orc, mustache, not the brave, and Orcbin Wood. So with a barbarian, a druid, a cleric, and a rogue. After the evil creature stole a local child, you have chased the necromancer back to their lair. The local tomb, a mile down the road from town. Out on the evil creatures, as you fly down the stairs of the tomb to a dimly lit hallway with an open door ahead of you. You stop and wait a few seconds for your eyes to adjust to the darkness before you proceed. So, let's have some light. Okay, so this is the starting area, well decorated. Below the evil creature, you are now stuck in my home. Thank you for the young child. Oh, sorry, my English is still too slow to read this. I will let you read as you like. Well, the necromancer is taunting us on the corridor. We won't take the long rest now. Opening the door leads to an old large underground tomb full of mausoleum for the local of the town. Some of the stonework has fallen to disarray over the years, now laying on the ground in heaps of rubble. This town does not have enough gold to repair its resting place. But they have enough money to light candles everywhere. Still, this is something that we can hope for in the future, having the assets without light, without candle. Okay, so there is a fight here. Oops. Can we use this? Why do you move?
I don't believe it.
Oh, nice. Okay, so barbarian, you will. This is 4 zombies.
You suck.
2-1 in a row. This is a nice start. Maybe you can do better. We will try. Okay, not so bad.
Well done.
Well, not the start that we... there is 2 more. Not the start that we can wish for, but well, so far we can see that this is a really well decorated map. I'm not very fond of the corridor, but well, it's a corridor. So with what we have, it's not that simple to decorate this, but the rooms are well fulfilled. Now 6 zombies for the start at level 1. Maybe a little too much. We have the surprise round, but technically we will not have it. Well, we will use a rage. You are in the need of healing. Okay.
More. Nice. Not bad, eh?
Okay, all zombies in the melee.
Come on!
Oops, one down already. Yeah, zombies are great creatures, but there is a lot here for a start. So the question is what we will face later if we start like this. We will try to see, but
you'll die anyway.
Hoping that we won't all die. No, but it's our cleric that is on the floor.
No quarter nice. Given.
Okay. Well, this is important to try the module in a authentical mode, of course, to check the balance of encounters. But I warn already, but you already know if you follow this video, that I will go into a story mode if we lose a fight, in order to avoid having a video with 4 hours of the same battle.
Well struck.
but so far it's okay. Even though we have two failures. Well, I understand why Tactical Adventure didn't allow the player to play without four characters, but it's a shame that that we are game over if one die, because the three others might be able to continue. So I understand that technically they will have to work a lot to ensure the game campaign work well without four characters, eventually with three or two or one, because every cinematics and stuff are impacted by this, but it's a little sad. This means that that if you want to see the end of the game, you have to not die. Just this. So this is from a single character point of view, it's okay to not die in order to reach the end of its story. But from a party point of view, the party might be able to see the end, even if some of them died. Here it is. So we will load this and go story mode, because I don't want to spend 4 hours on fights. Well, this is not my my jam usually, but especially on videos, because you watch it, so do you really want to watch 4 hours of the same battle? I don't think so. Maybe I'm wrong, but so we will just jump straight to story mode. Okay. And try to finish this quick. Well, I understand that that there is
no quarter given.
Players that really like the fight challenge and are not really fond of stories and stuff. It's okay, but this not makes a
you die like the rest.
A decent video, in my opinion. But this is my opinion. So if you have another, it's okay.
More coming your way.
But that said, starting with this kind of hard fight, I'm curious to see what will follow in this adventure. Maybe a good thing to start with this, but we'll see.
Keep them coming.
Okay. No, we won't move. Don't you just come here? No, not possible. So
I win again.
Well, the idea of an adventure is that on a small map we will reach the end from the start with no long rest. Okay, this is the point. Maybe we will have a long rest to take, but so far I don't know. So for me, this is just the first fight of a small map. So I won't use my spells, okay? If it was a D&D tabletop scene, I would probably use my spell because I know that there will be a boss fight and a starting fight and maybe a third fight in the middle, but this is already 4 hours of gameplay. So I'm able to manage my spells for the adventure like this, but with this video game we don't know what the player thinks. So maybe there will be tons and tons of fights with zombies. Maybe there will be only 3 fights, so the first one, the main one, and the boss. Okay. But as it's a video game, also, we don't really know what the creators might think about this. I know that DM, like game master on tabletop, are really aware of the fight balance and the fight time that it takes and stuff. Okay. So you know when you start an adventure on an afternoon that you won't have a fight on fight on fight on fight. Okay, there will be one, maybe two, maybe three, but it's already a long afternoon if you have three. So there for the video game, I will always start by okay, I won't use my spells because behind this there might be a lot of fights and stuff, but maybe not. Maybe it's well balanced, but we'll see.
Palpable hit.
Okay, let's go. So this tend to make the first fight maybe a little harder than it would be because I won't use spells. Okay, this is the point. Can see that even in story mode this is long enough. It's also maybe my lack of English understanding, but I tend to feel this fight is like coming a little from nowhere. The text speak about a necromancer, okay?
A fine stroke.
But what is the intent here? Like our party, what are we doing here? Why this necromancer? I will, of course, go into the dungeon maker before giving my notes, in order to reread things quietly and stuff, but. I feel like this first fight is coming a little from nowhere. So I don't know. Oh, Okay, we will have a better chance by hitting him, but as he already been wounded.
A modest success.
Though I like the feeling of the decoration. Necropolis is the first environment that we had on the Dungeon Maker, so we did eat this a lot because it was the only one environment for a long time. Okay, so now this is a little hard for new creators to provide surprises or new feeling with Necropolis. Okay, but with this map I feel like it's okay. I don't like this corridor. I feel it's a little empty, but the start was good, and this next room is really good. So it's more like I feel more like a little city undead than because of this asset. Okay, the mausoleum, it's very very rich tomb, so we can assume on the upper ground that this is not a village but a town. Okay. And maybe this inspires me the will of making an undead city underground, but we will have to wait a little more for Dungeon Maker updates.
Kill 'em all.
If it's an if, but if at some point we can use the monsters as NPC, we can do a very good underground cities with that. This will be very very nice. We can already do with eventually dwarves and but it won't feel the same if we don't have undead, but still we have a ghost that we can use. Maybe I will try this for myself and Oldenburg Chronicle campaign.
Good kill.
Okay, this is done. See that even in story mode this is but when you create your map, always do an authentical mode.
Harder.
Okay. And try the fights several times if possible, because sometimes you have the good dice and sometimes you haven't. But if you try in story mode, you won't feel the same balance for the fight for the encounter. So it will be very bad to consider story mode while testing your own map when creating it. So stuck to authentical mode when creating. Okay, so I feel this fight was a little too hard for the well. It's not that bad that the fight is a little too hard. Okay, it may be bad if there is a lot of fight behind. If this is the first fight and then there is a main fight and then a last fight, maybe it's okay. We will see. So there is nice. It's a great gift, this Aversak so soon. But nice one. We'll see. Take care also with the amount of magical loot that you provide. But this fight was hard. I think this is a real reward for this. It's a nice one. Not too powerful, but still very useful. This door is locked with a brass lock. Okay. Once again, I won't use the alt key except if we are stuck for a long time. But there is already something happening.
No!
Oh. Sorry, I was watching right there if there was a button. I was a little too slow on my spacebar. Okay, walking by the worn and crumbling mausoleum, you trip on a small rock and lean on the doorway to steady yourself. Okay, so this is another fight.
Not that the next one.
In the encounter category that jury member will not. This is not only the CR level compared to the character level. Okay. This is also the balance overall on the map and stuff. I have to admit that. To fight in a row right after this this strong first fight, I'm not too fond of, but maybe some players are. Just because this is a
no quarter given.
How can I say this? The fights are turn-based, okay? So this is a long time fixed on a position and fighting, of course, but not moving into the story. So for me, this is each fight is a possible way. To slow your story and break the rhythm of a story, and the first one was a long fight and a hard fight. Okay, so this need to break the story in order to make the fight. There we have some sort of a puzzle or riddle, I don't know, to go in our way. And when we start to think about it, there is another fight who break the story and the rhythm of the adventure. So this is for me a problem, because now I'm not on the story at all, I'm just on the fight for a long time now, and it would have been longer if we haven't jumped into story mode. So it's more like a dungeon crawler now, okay. But with a story that we need to follow, so it's not very compatible. Either you make
you'll die like the rest.
A real good story, okay, but this will need a lighter fight in order to move into the story and don't forget what you have to do and stuff. Okay. Or you want to make a dungeon crawler with a lot of fights, it's okay as well, but the story will need to be lighter than this. No full sentence of 4 or 5 lines everywhere and stuff. You have to adapt the amount of lore compared to the amount of fight, and this is the encounter balance. Okay, this is a part of it. Also, I will consider that English is not my main language. Okay. For English speakers, this will be maybe easier to read. So I will also take this in consideration. Maybe the rhythm will be a little more increased because they can read faster, but still this is a fight and a lot of round. Okay, there is also maybe if a player roll a 20 on each dice, this can be a little faster, but. Well, all is about
you're still in the fight, my friend.
Balance. Because in our story, in our games, when we play, we like that there is a challenge. We like that the boss are our boss and stuff. But and if you are a D&D player on tabletop, because you have one afternoon to spend with your game. You want that okay, there will be maybe one fight only during the adventure of the day, but you want it a little challenging and stuff because there is only one fight, okay, even though it's a long campaign and you will have a lot of fights, etc. But this video game, because it's a video game, people tend to think that it can be a hack and slash. And there can be a lot of monsters everywhere and stuff, but this is not the D&D spirit at all. So even if you make a dungeon crawler with D&D, you have to understand that a lot of monsters are not match very well with the thing. Or eventually you can custom the monster so that they have only one hit point, for example. Okay, so one hit and it's dead, so that you can add a little more and not break too many the rhythm of your story. See what I mean? If every fight is hard, like D&D is usually, but D&D tabletop, so there is only one fight in the day, or maybe two, maybe three if you spend a long time with your friend, but
well struck.
Well, I don't know if I'm clear because of my lack of vocabulary in English, but know that in my head this is very
only the last blow matters.
Very a thing. Well, also there is the fight that I comment what I see and what I do and stuff. So this is not a really good thing to be in a story. Really in it. But the two fights in a row that long is not helping me.
A victory fit for a song.
Okay, so now that we have done this, maybe we can restart to think about. Okay, we need to move there. Don't you want to come with us? Okay, and the sentences do not appear again, so if there was a clue. I don't know what it is. Okay.
Stop. A trap.
Yeah, there is another trap. So you see, after a fight, we tend to go on a lore stage or eventually exploration stage and stuff. We move during a story, no matter the story, we move between sequences. And during these sequences of understanding of our environment, we were interrupted by the second fight, which is for me too much. So I will have either delete this second fight or reduce the first fight and combine the second fight right after or something like that, in order to not cut the sequences of this area that much. But it's my opinion. Okay, once again, I try to judge the creation on my very point of view and what I like, what I dislike. But if you like this, it's okay to do this. There's no problem at all. But from a story point of view, this is a heartbreak in it. Okay, I don't play Druid at all, so I will pick randomly and see what happens. Okay. Are we something here? No, there is not. Can we go there? No, we can't. So there is something, a plate, or I don't know. I will agree to the alt button at some point. Okay. Oh, there is nothing. Are we stuck? Because we missed the lockpick. Well, it will be a very short video if we are like soft lock first room. Now we had the haversack here. Okay. Well. Okay. Well, second time it's okay. But there is a huge problem here, because if we hadn't a rogue in our group and a second character that can also pick and open the door, check the DC, it can be a real soft clock here, and that's it, end of the story. So this is not a thing that I would recommend. If you really want to create the player, like I understand that okay, this door was locked, and the creator wants us to pick the door. The problem is, if we can't, then we are soft lock and stuck forever in these two rooms, and won't be able to see the end of the module. Okay, so this is a real gameplay problem. So the tips is, what do you want to do? What is your intent with this door? if it's just a mood thing, okay, you can totally put this door locked, but with a DC like 1, so it's an automatic success. But the player won't know this, okay, only you will know. So the player will think, oh, okay, I got a success and I opened the door. This is creating a story. Like providing to the player something that he might enjoy. You are not here to stuck him in any way. And if you are a game master, like a tabletop one, eventually you can check with your players and all agreed on a DM versus players. Okay, but this is not a good way to provide a story. This is a good way for a dungeon crawler, okay, DM versus player. But here, with all the amount of lore that we had before, we understand that the creator wants us to follow a story. So soft lock is the worst thing that can happen, and we are very lucky that it's okay now. But take a really great care with this. It's not a problem if you give something to player in order to support your mood for your story. Okay, but you have to choose between story first or challenging the player. But softlock is not a challenge. Softlock is just the player will move on and play something else. You press the button, then behind you, you hear several clicks. Okay, I'm sorry, this is my my English, I can't read that fast. Here, we can't... Well, there is no way, I don't know, well, I know why I look here. Because with Aurora toolset and Neverwinter Night, we can totally... erased objects with a button or something, some sort of trigger. So my first idea is, okay, we push the button, then something moved, but no, this is not possible with Solasta for now. And so we are here with our traps that we can't untrap because they are oriented one on the other. So this is a good thing, but the first one should be accessible to the player, and then the other one might require that the player success to untrap them one by one. Okay, this is a good thing that we have seen. I think it's a Servando's map on the CODM1 that used that trick. We had to unlock a first trap first in order to access the others, but here the two are not accessible, so okay. Oh, but the button make them not not dangerous, so it's okay. But still, I think even though there is this, I think this might be accessible. Okay, I would like to try this one, but it's also disarmed by the button. Because, you know why? Because this button, okay, is an option. If the player is focused enough on this adventure, okay, we'll disable and then he will be rewarded that the traps are disarmed. But if it's not, he might be able to cross and maybe have a chance to disarm them. So this This might be accessible. You can't see very far in the unlit hallway. The few feet that you can see in, you are sure you can make out a tomb. Other than that, you see the same statue that line the walls. The same statue, sorry. My reading is worse than my understanding. Okay, this is a long sword plus one. Do we have someone? Eventually, who have you? Can we identify the thing? No, we can't because we're level 1. You don't have anything. Well, see the corridor? Okay, there is tomb everywhere, but it feels already better than the first one, where there is only statues. I understand that this is an entrance, but even an entrance, maybe you can use something to make it a little more. Also, because there is the fire camp. So why this fire camp is here? Okay, I requested it in the rules, so I know why there is one, but why in this room there is one? There is nothing else. Maybe you can add some bench or something to make us understand that there is some life around that will justify that the fire camp is here. I don't know if I'm clear with this this thing, but I hope I am. Though the map is nice, but there is things for me at least. You can. Have another opinion, it's okay, and you'll be able to vote for maps by yourself if you want. Just have to get the okay. Another door locked, so I will just check the corridor if there is a button or something. Okay, so maybe what can happen is that there is an activator just in front of the loot. Because I didn't loot, maybe the door didn't move. Yeah, there is an activator, so but it was for a monster. Well, okay, I can't fight. I want to fight this. Whoops. Okay. This is.
Perhaps if you tried to be loud instead.
It was a fight with the space bar in order to have the surprise round. But there may be have other activators. This is why you need to test your map
next time,
and then to, if possible, make it test by another player, because you have a way to create your map and to think about your story and your puzzle and your riddles, okay, and this is nice, but this is not enough. Why this is not enough? Because
the
player won't play like you do. Never. Like never. They never play like you think they will do. So if you don't test yourself first, maybe you will miss a big mistakes. And if you are not able to make your map tested by someone else, you will miss some things like that, because I won't have loot the things, but maybe I won't be able to open the door if I don't loot the things. But what happens if I don't want to loot the things? See what I mean? There is players who don't like to loot things and just go forward, and this is okay. So you don't have to encase your player into your way of thinking. So this is a little tricky, okay? Because we also want to provide a story, so this is a way of thinking of constructing and making progress a story. But this is also a balance between how much your player will be free to play as he will want to play. And I can say that coming back and returning and re-coming back and it's not a very very good way. I don't know if some of you have already mapped a track on Trackmania. So this is a race game, okay, with a track editor. I invite you to try it if you want, because Trackmania Nations is totally free. So you can download it and use the map editor, okay? It's that kind of simple, okay? So you will have blocks of roads and you can make them side by side, and you have your map and your track for your races. This is the same thing for a racing map than for a story with encounters map. The things have to be smooth as possible. You don't want that when you create a track that your wheel be stuck between two spaces of a road and stuff. You want the road as smooth as possible in order to have the best driving sensation as possible. The story in a RPG is exactly the same spirit. You have to make it smooth as possible in order to create the most sensation as possible for your player. So coming back, if it's not really important for the story, if the story doesn't, if it's not a real need of the story, just go forward, continue to move. So ouais, well, once again, I don't know if I'm very clear, but this is
I thought you could fight.
A strong thought from me. I really think that things must have been to be must have to be smooth as possible. Not like my English diction, but
still, I
try to make it
this.
Smooth as I can. But this encounter is just a candy flavor encounter. So, for example, if you want to pop up a skeleton like this for no special reason, you can create a reason with some plagues and I don't know, a scroll on the floor with I don't know, but there is a here it's a little free, okay? So free is not very good while you want to provide a story. If you want to provide a dungeon crawler, it's okay, because it's a dungeon crawler and the story is reaching monsters and reaching the end. But in this case, I feel we are in between two things, but not not in the best.
Wait till the next one.
But this is a knight, a skeleton, not just a skeleton. So there's no explanation of what is this skeleton. Why? Are you maybe a lord or something? Do you protect something? Why are you jumping at us? I don't forget that there is an necromancer in the corner order. That we are eventually hunting. Yeah. Well, this is a video game stuff. If you add monster, no matter the kind of game, but if you are adding monster and monster and monster, okay, you are providing a hack and slash. Slash dungeon crawler adventure. Okay, so you don't need a real story. It's just monster die! First. But if you start to provide real stories, you have to balance a little more. Why are you providing the monster? And think about the justification of there is a monster here because of what? Also, don't be afraid to make a short maps, okay? Or short sequences in your adventures. I try to imagine this fight in authentic mode, plus the other fight before and the other fight before. It's already a long time of playing, but for only three doors. You see, so this is maybe something to balance overall. This monster here is not a bad monster. It's a good encounter for level 1 because it's hard enough and stuff. But now, why? Who is this skeleton? Yes, this is maybe the question that you can ask yourself while you create a map and you add a monster. Who is this monster? Is it the inhabitant of the place? Is it a guardian of something? Is it a leader? Is it a traveler who come by? Is it a resident? I don't know. Is it a... And for this skeleton, I don't really know who it is. The spiders were okay because we have seen a lot of webs and stuff. Okay, the zombies, of course, we can understand that there will be zombies. So why they are jumping on us like this? Maybe they are a guardian, but this would have been said. I don't think that all stories need to explain all of what's happening on the screen, but I think that character justification and location justification, things like that, need to be included in the story. okay, there were a necromancer with his guardian. He was an ancient lord, and he has a main general army. This is this one maybe. So we, when we read the name of the guy, we know already. Oh, this is the general army of the necromancer, and when he pop up. Then we know that there is a reason, because it's a general army, so he will defend his master and see what I mean.
Hold firm! You've endured worse!
Okay, finally. Well, this was a long fight, but this one is okay. I'm okay with this fight, but maybe a little more knowledge around it in order to justify the fight. Okay, so we took some object and a key that is probably needed for the door. So this means, okay. This means we are forced to loot things in order to make the encounter appear, and then we can unlock the door. This is how can I say this? This is not very good, because like we did, we were not interested in the loot. We just command the door, it was locked. But there was no option to open it. No button, no plate, no nothing. Okay, so the idea was, okay, I want to open my door with a key, and I want the player find this key. No problem, but the key was on a fight. The key should have been maybe hidden in the stuff directly, not on the monsters. This is maybe something that you might think not so important, but this is a lot, because we have maybe the opportunity to grab the key without the fight. Also, if you really want, we have the fight, because we have pick up the key, then you put the key on the thing, and in your knowledge, your model knowledge with your black screen, you can say, oh no, you have touched my key and stuff, and you won't disturb the master, and you can reconnect with the who is this guy. Okay, you see the importance is on the link that you can create for the player to understand your dungeon, your story, plus the justification of okay, we need a key to open the door and stuff. Eventually you can put a knowledge here, oh it seems that we need a key. Okay, so this is a good way to make us coming back, and okay, we will search for a key now. I think the word is justification. If you don't want to make a dungeon crawler, and even if you do, think about justification of what is on the screen, what is the action you want the player to do and stuff, and why. This is very important for the story and the mood while playing the adventure.
Yeah.
I won't miss next time.
Okay. This is done. You don't have to bet on an activator that the other way will be to put your activator in all the length of the corridor. Okay? So that the player, even if we go this way, the monster will pop up or you won't move further. I will stop you and stuff. But using only one area is a little tricky. As you step through the silver locked door, you step into a well-lit dilapidated room with two sarcophagi in despair in the center of the room. To the south is a large pile of rubble near the one sarcophagus.
There's a trap.
Is there? Well, this is a very rogue friendly this adventure. There is a nice dagger which is already known, so we can use it. Not with you, it's with Orgbin Wood. Okay, this is for you. Or maybe I should put it. Okay, we can't go there. Yeah, we can. There is a no button. Okay, now we're stuck. Eventually, we have another character. I think it's you. Oh, yeah, it's okay. It's okay. And now we can't disarm these traps. So is there a button like the first time? I can't see a button anywhere. So what we can't do with skill points, we will with heal points. Okay. There is an ogre something around. Oh, this is zombie. Oh, this is the room. See, this minimap is very, like I imagine really easily an undead city. I really hope that tactical adventure will allow us to use monsters as NPC, because it will be epic to visit an undead city. I won't wait for the DM update to try it, but probably I will need it. Okay,
get us all killed.
Well, I tried. Oh, there is a lot of people. Once again, there is four zombies, basic skeleton, and an archer. Well, let's fight. Also, to come back on what I said earlier, it was don't be afraid to make shorter stories and stuff, because this is how much. This is already a long time. I don't exactly know how much time we spent on this map already.
Again, harder.
But the rhythm is more important than the length, okay? So if your rhythm is good, it's okay to have a short map, because the player will enjoy and then will want more. So that you can add another map and continue the story. And it's totally fine. This is often the new creator trap. When you create something for the first time, you tend to you want to make it epic and very okay. I will add this and this and this and this and this and add a lot of stuff, and this is way too big to the understanding and the. And the rhythm, so don't be afraid to make short maps with really singular fights and singular environment and stuff. Though this environment is very good. I'm not fond of the fights and the fight breaking the stories.
Bleed!
Okay. Two down. Or maybe three.
Not bad, eh?
Yes, the archer skeletal, you can use maybe two or three, because they will miss a lot. So it's like a ghost encounter. Not so long to kill and not very dangerous. If you want to frighten the player, you can add two or three more, because he will think, oh, maybe they can hit me, but they won't. And or maybe one time on 10 they will eat, but it's more for the mood than the challenge. So don't be shy with the skeletal archers. For the recall, we are in story mode, so the fight is a little faster than what will it be in authentic mode. But even then, the story is like stop and go.
Perhaps
stop and go story. Well, this is hard to explain, because it's also normal to have knowledge, then fight, then knowledge, exploration and stuff. I don't know exactly why, well, I know I tried to explain it, but why this map and not some others are feeling this way. But I think maybe the knowledge were too much. There is a good amount of knowledge, but too many fights, or too long fights.
Again, harder.
You can add, for example, one skeleton, one zombies, one spider, one thing. The player will totally crush the thing. But this will give the mood that okay, this is there is a lot of people around, but there is not. There is only four that you crushed away. But this is just a flavor fight. Okay, this is not something for the fight. This is something for the mood, and I tend to think that the three fight that we had here was for the flavor, but conceived as the real fights. So this is three real fights plus one. So this is already four fights in two rooms. This is a lot. Okay. But once again, this is my my opinion. If you have another, it's okay. It's totally fine. If you prefer. Alors, when I say you, it's not the map creator. It's you, a general you, okay. You who maybe are interested in this review or in a review in general of a map.
One less enemy.
This is done. Okay, there is a lot of loot. This is too many loot for. Well, I'm expecting now that the final fight will be hard. Like really hard, because it tend to prepare us with a lot of big loot.
There's a trap.
But this is a little too much reward. Well, globally, this is a okay. So this will be no. We have no magician. But I understand also that on this map you add something for a magician, for a rogue, for a fighter, for something. Then you add a lot of objects in order to please every possible party. I understand that, but. It's not necessary in the end. You don't have to please everyone. Okay, there was a key, so take care with this, because we were close to miss the key. So why there was a key on this random creature. This is something that can be justified as well, because otherwise I will just think, oh, it's a zombie, I don't need the loot. So This door is locked with a dragon lock. Okay. That reminds me the Vel's map of the COD 1. With his dragon. Sorry, I was trying the door again and again while thinking of the Vel's map. Okay. So, what can we do without the dragon key? But the indication was okay on the door. We know that we need a dragon key. Now, okay, how can we have it? Maybe there is an activator somewhere with an encounter and a dragon key on it. But it's not a very good way to provide a key like with no like we have to roam every square in order to maybe unlock something. Okay, I will use a lot the alt key, but there is nothing. I don't think we missed loot. So we will just come back and check. This is a little problem as well. Like the same with this door. Same problem. Thinking that the player will find the stuff right away, because as creator you know where it is, but as player you don't know nothing, like Jon Snow. And you are totally lost on the map, so this is not good for the gameplay. Because when you are player, you don't like to be lost. Okay, so maybe we missed something. We will try every sarcophagus. I thought I already tried them, but... maybe I miss one. Oh, we miss this. Let's open this bad boy. Okay. This is a lot of loot. A lot. I take it, but if you do this with this map, okay, what will be this map edition 2, like the next part? Is there some magical object left in the DM? Also, we are level 2, so this is a little too much for level 2 party. Well, we have seen everything, and no dragon key. So come back here. Well, this is nice to see. I'm sorry if it's not like a commentary, like wow, this map is very good and stuff. There is very good things, but we are here to point the things that maybe are not so good in order to improve in the future. But know that every creator from every game come by this kind of mistakes and stuff, and no map is perfect first, okay, and no one makes perfect map like never, especially not the first maps. It's okay. To have mistake and the map for a new creator is good. I don't. It's not a bad map. But it's a map with like it's not mapping mapping mistakes. It's more of a level design mistakes, if you see what I mean. Like what I will propose to my player, how can I encourage him to do this or that and stuff. This is not very mapping, because mapping is the consequences of your level design conception. So it's more of a conception problem than an execution problem, but in the end what we see is the execution mistakes. So where is this dragon key? I don't know at all. Okay, this is locked. We have all here. Oh, there is something here that we... So, the party will come back at some point. Here we are not in the gameplay. Here we are just in the... Okay, I'm soft lock. So, this is not normal. So, there might be something to do. But this is not a puzzle. This is not a riddle. This is just a... Okay, here it is, but this is not the dragon key. So, what have we missed? But there is something here. Sorry, my bad. I would have take all the first time. But there is no dragon key. There is all the objects plus the magical focus. So this is a very good thing to add. Okay, so now there is another chest. This is not a chest, this is the statue. Okay, this is an iron key. But it's like more cheating than playing, because I'm looking at the map and check what I missed and but even though I missed stuff, there is no dragon key, so I'm little afraid that we will try the door with the two new keys. But there is a dragon key in the dungeon maker, so I strongly hope that there is no mistake with the choice of the keys and the text related to the keys. Okay, so this is still locked. Maybe we can try the button once again. But what is the dragon related thing? If there is something to do with this button. No, this is okay. Okay. Now that I've pushed the button several times, like maybe in order to activate, desactivate, deactivate, sorry, symmetrical stuff. Or maybe there is an hidden door. No, I don't think there is enough space on the walls. Well, well, well. No, there is nothing. And of course, there is a DC 13, so we won't be able to open the door. Oh, maybe, maybe with a. No, we can't reach 13. Can we? If we have 20, we will be 20. Well, let me check. So, no, we can't. We can't do this. Well, so for now I'm soft lock because the door asks for a dragon key that we don't have. Though we have several keys that we found. That we found on corpses, but maybe we missed an encounter. I will run in the middle here if there is the encounter. No. We'll try to run everywhere. Where is this key? Well, I'm not searching the key, I'm searching the trigger. Maybe unlock a fight where maybe creature will have the key. But if I can't finish this, this will be very bad. Not that the map was not nice to roam, but from a gameplay point of view, this is very big mistake. Though I might miss a really big thing that you all are seeing. Now maybe screaming behind your computer. Oh Matt, this is here. Why can't you see it? But I really don't. Well, well, well. Okay. So what will I do? It's I will save the game. Yeah. Okay. I will jump into the DM with you. We will check this. Okay, so this is Copperick. Okay, we will jump into the DM. Yes, this is this. And we will check together where the dragon key is and what is the door. The door thing. Now this is a location. Copperick. Okay. Here we are. So this we start here. Okay, we have done the thing here. And we are stuck here. So the door needs the draconic key. It's okay now. Where is the draconic key? We will check all creatures. Oh, there is a teleporter, but the teleporter didn't teleported us. But this is linked. This is activated. What is the problem? Okay, we will try to. But even though we are coming here. Oh, see, the draconic. Yes, sorry. See is a. Is yes in a. In French. Well, the draconic key is here, so we have to be teleported in order to continue. We will try to trigger the thing. Maybe this is a bug, I don't know. I thought that we come in front of this mausoleum, but maybe not. Oh, because the... Yes, I know why. Because the teleporter isn't visible. And because we need the 4 character on the teleporter to be activated, then we come in front of the thing, but not with the 4 characters, and then the teleportation not triggered. So this is a mistake. This is a gameplay mistake, even though this is my mistake first, okay? Because I didn't roam every square and stuff. But how can I understand that there is a TP here that will need 4 characters in here? This is not possible. So, well, this was possible because we look at the DM, but if you don't know, you are just soft lock here and you will roam quick in there, but no trigger, so... well, you see what happened. This was it. So we will be able to finish this this map, but this was I will consider it as a soft lock here because we had to jump on the DM to unlock ourselves. So this is not that bad. This is not as bad as if the key were forgotten or something. But there is a gameplay issue here. And I think this sort of issue can be solved by playtesting the map a little more and making another player to playtest the map. Because if someone played this this map before me, okay, well, I mean, not a jury member, but if Koperik gave this map to someone else before submitting the map, I'm 100% certain that that the player would have said, "Oh, I'm locked here. Why? How can I jump forward?" And if Koperik answers this question, this is a bad thing. Okay, so you won't be able. When you submit a map, when you publish it on the workshop or something, you won't be able to contact the player and explain everything and stuff. Okay, you can maybe create a tip and trick stuff and answer a comment and stuff, but you have to consider that you won't be able to do this. So the player is totally alone in your map, and this is something to consider as well. How can he solve his own problem? So first you try to create no problem for him, but then eventually add something, some bit of lore about I don't know, about, oh, there is a fresh air somewhere here, this might be a link to some something else, I don't know, a secret place. So the player will then roam around this place and seeking for something, but not knowing what. You have to invite your player to roam the place where you want him to find something. But the clue about the draconic key was good. On the door, there is a need of a draconic key. It's a good thing because we knew that we missed something, okay? So we can try to search something, but the thing that we have to find is not well managed. or the situation. Okay, there is this, the skeleton, sorcerer. There is another. No, this is this is already a big fight for the skeleton key. Is this the last fight? Maybe. I don't know because I suppose, but I guess. Well, the thing is, the map is good, but well, there is good good intent, there is good decoration, okay. I understand that Copperic is a good mapper, like a mapper, an environment mapper, okay. Still with things to improve, like the corridor entrance and the justification of this fire camp. Maybe mapping issues to help the player understand where the creator want him to go. There is little trouble with the knowledge because it was not very clear. Well, the draconic key needed is a very clear clue. It's good, okay. But well, I felt lost in the map, and the knowledge didn't help. So this is I don't want that the knowledge become a tutorial, okay. But this has to be a little in a video game, especially when you create custom things because we are not professional creators. So maybe we have to explain a little more than professionals in order to make the player comfortable with what we created for him, because this is for the player that we do this. Okay, we as creator take pleasure to create, and we are very happy to provide our own stories and stuff, but what we do here is for the player, so we have to think a little more on this map of the player more than the creator. And this, I think, would have been said by someone else if Operic had a playtester, but this is something to ask. I understand that we don't have necessarily available players, but this is something to seek and to ask from a creator point of view. We don't have to wait for the player to playtest our map. We have to ask them to playtest. This is an effort, this is time spent for us that the player will provide or not. But this is a real thing to do from a creator point of view. Asking for playtesters. And this is what Texture Adventure do with this game, and every other game do as well, and this is for this exact reason. Finding bugs, it's a thing, but being clear with the player, the player feeling comfortable with the game enough to reach it to the end. This is why at first we have playtesters. But it's okay, once again, no map is perfect. even from professional creators, nothing is perfect. They can only every time improve stuff. So we are not professional, so it's okay to do mistakes. And I like to see a new map from Copperic with this kind of trouble fixed, because I think this Copperic you can be a really good mapper in the end, but you have to improve on well, from my point of view.
No quarter given.
On the level design overall things. So also you have to understand, I say that for everyone that is looking this video, that is watching this video. Understand that every creator who map something with this game or with another game, no matter the game, well, particularly this kind of game, like tactical CRPG stuff, understand that the professionals don't map a thing alone, okay? There is someone who decorate the map, someone who create the tactical fight needs, someone who create the fight. So this is already three people for one map, okay? And maybe other people for other aspects of the map. So understand that when you create a map alone, like this with an editor, you actually do four jobs different. So this is a good map for a starting creator alone. I think this is not a bad map, but there is mistakes to correct, like big mistakes, sadly, but this is not an empty map, an empty map of everything. This is not this has potential, but for now with big mistakes that really have to be fixed. But I think you will fix it very soon. The best way well, maybe not the best way, but one of the way that I want to propose is to think of the player first. No matter what you do, think of the player. Okay, he won't. No matter the reader, if I think it's very clear and stuff, he won't understand what I want to do. So this is the first thing to help make it more easier in the writing. But even though you think this is the easiest way you can do, make it test by another player who will say if it's actually okay, it's easy, I understand, no problem, or if he will mess with the map and be totally lost like I was in this one. And if he says that I was lost, I didn't understand this and that and stuff, I know that often a creator might be a little egomaniac and say you didn't find the stuff that I want you to find, you're a bad player actually. But yep, maybe I'm a bad player, but I won't be alone. And if you want a player come back to see your next map and stuff, you have to put the player in the first place in your video game creation. So this is
You like that?
This is a little bit like like art, but because it's a video game and player need to reach the end of your story, this can't be 100% like art, and you have to consider the other other players, and especially the bad players and the casual players, because they are the most numerous community.
Wait till the next one.
They will play your map, and if it's not smooth enough, then they will just move on and never try your map again. Okay, only hardcore gamer will accept that there is mistake and come back and recheck and replay and this is not the this is a very good thing. I like the way that hardcore player don't move on so quickly. But if you want that your map is played and that player will follow your next maps, then you have to understand that the player should come first. You create a story to them, to make them enjoy their life better and enjoy Solasta a little more. Oh, okay, we have been teleported once again, but this is just a camera issue that this camera follow have been reported already to Tactical Adventure. They know the thing, but so far they can't fix the thing. I know that Servando is actually really like he's asking for this fix for a long time now. A lot of the room is in massive disrepair. The hall to the south is the way out. You can see some light spilling in down the stairwell. So this was, you see the knowledge so far are knowledge used to create and explain the room, but not to explain the story. Do you understand what I mean? So I would like that the knowledge would have been okay, explaining the room and the situation, like okay, there are no money, so the thing is collapsing and stuff, but there is no mention of who is buried here and stuff, so there is something missing in the knowledge as well. Wow. Okay. This is a surprise. So I will say this again. I already said this. It was not a CODM map. It was just a review of another dungeon, like random in the workshop long time ago. And the creator did a final fight with a dragon. Okay, then another fight with a vampire plus some undead right before the end. Okay, but as we had done the final fight already, the next fight was very very boring, because it was long, because we can see the end and we already had spent some time for the final fight and stuff. So do not add a fight after the boss fight. This is like mandatory. If you want really to add flavor, you can add a skeleton like alone roaming here, if eventually you speak about or there is the skeleton Humfred who leave his grave for a long time. We can't find him and stuff. Okay, you do your story, you make your final fight, and there at the end there is Humfred alone roaming. Oh, we found it. But other than a joke like this or a little bit of flavor, but a really quick fight. Don't do this. Don't ever. Don't. Just don't. Please.
Yeah! More.
Because after the boss fight, the player should reach the end. This is like if you so you can make an open ending. So after the end, there is a knowledge. We speak about the boss flee and we can cross him later. And I don't know. Okay. But you have to end the sequence. The map, the chapter, I don't know how you structure your adventure, but you have to end after a boss fight. Because otherwise this is not a boss fight. So maybe this is the boss fight, but it will be very low compared to the boss fight, so it's a bit weird. So we will fight this because I want to reach the end no matter what, because I need to export the characters. So I say this we see this is Copperic, but I don't want Copperic to feel bad. These particular things, the fight after a boss fight, this is something that I already crossed in Solasta custom dungeons, and that I already had on video and speak about and stuff, but it was in French, so you probably don't cross it, but it's very important, I think. But this works for Solasta, this works for every other game, no matter the... Imagine that if you play Mario Bros and you beat Bowser, and then there is another fight and another fight. This won't have any flavor because the ending point is Bowser. So here the ending point was the Necromancer. Eventually, where there can be a fight after the boss fight is before the boss fight. If for example we forgot some chest to loot and stuff, and we didn't trigger all the fights, okay, there was a fight that we forget, then we have to fight, but it's okay, it's not telling that it's after the boss fight in the story. So this kind of fight is okay, but this one is very not.
Go to hell.
Okay, so we will run toward the melee. Oh, and see what happened.
Walk it off.
We spoke about the spells at the very first fight, and now we have still spells because it was not very clear. So I should use spells against the boss, and then I won't be able to use spells here because this fight doesn't have to exist at all. But now we will use spell because this is the very very last fight, and why do you want to throw your dagger? Because you are far away.
That's battle.
Yes, there is a... So basically the mapping was good. Okay. Not very good, there was a little things to improve, but this is for me the best aspect of the map. The decoration, the mood with the objects. Okay. the riddle, puzzle, seeking, searching aspect is to improve, like a lot, but it's easy to improve if you start to think about players first and not you first, okay? So you have to consider that what you will do, no matter who you are, is not as good as you think it is, and must be done in an easier way. So no matter what, it won't be perfect. No matter what, it's okay to have something not perfect. Like I'm saying this and
the maps
are not perfect and stuff, it's okay. But you have to consider this to the most you can make it a little more perfect. And the best way is to do this and then make player test your map and then accept what they say and change in order to help them. But understand that the player will probably not replay your map. So you will have to find another playtester after your change, so make it really good, because this is important for player. If you have a player who accept to playtest your map several times, this is a very very good thing, but I think this is not a very common thing. Yes, see why this fight is not necessary, because we have already spent a lot of time on the boss and stuff. There is no story to reach except eventually the very end, but this fight won't provide more lore than we can expect after killing the boss. So this is just time. This is just more time for a fight not necessary. You can cut this fight, you can cut I think the two first fights, you can remanage to make only one fight with eventually spiders and maybe the third fight here. Yeah, there is something to cut. I will let only two fights on the three proposed. The skeleton alone was good. Eventually you can let him alone as well, there's no need for the other one. And you can, by cutting all these fights, win probably 1 hour of gameplay. Which is very good, because we can think, oh, there is not a lot of gameplay, so this is not a good thing. We want more hours of gameplay, but no, this is not working like this. I prefer 30 minutes or 45 minutes of real good rhythm with two fights and a real good story with no coming back to search a key that maybe I forgot or something. And
truly formidable.
Fighting and fighting and fighting. But there is good thing. This is not
no quarter given.
Copperic is not a bad creator at all. I don't think no one is. It's just a starting creator, so. It's a good start, but it's a start. Now it's time to
lucky
to improve.
Perhaps.
But know that we all, like everyone, did the same mistakes, and it's why I'm not so shy to tell this is a mistake and this is not, but even though I'm not a professional at all. But I did this mistake before, and this is because player told me, you don't have this, you don't have to do this and stuff. Well, the fight after the boss fight, I didn't do this, but because we are not the same, we won't all do the same mistakes and some mistakes we will avoid because we think this or that way and we won't avoid the same. So lucky for me, I avoided this one because this is something that I dislike in other games. But at some point I did other mistakes. And I will do again. So we have one character down now. Okay, you will die first.
Again,
how can we tell the mother of that child? They have been slain for the fun of it. Once we leave this place, we will never be the same. But I'm glad that monster is dead. Well, it's not actually. Let us move. Yes. Yes, please. Oh, but there is another one. Okay. But only this one maybe would have been enough. Okay. Oh yes, protection. It's time to rage. I forgot since many turns now. Wow. Lucky for us, we don't see the storm. Okay. Yeah.
Wait till the next one.
But it's okay now that we have seen this and that we could talk about it. Maybe we won't ever see this again. From Copperic, I'm certain that this mistake won't happen again. Well, I hope strongly.
That I like.
And please spread the word if you talk with another creators, and if they ask, should I create another fight after my boss fight? No, the answer is no. Like for the whole community, please say no.
More coming your way.
Please eat. Yes.
No quarter given.
Okay, there is one left. Plus, maybe Orgei will be okay. So, this is for you. Oh, but there is protection. Okay, okay. I don't know why this fight was added. Was it because Copperic thought, maybe my map is too short, and so I will add a few minutes of more gameplay with this fight. I think, I guess this is why. But so we can say what we have. Said earlier, don't be shy to create short maps. It's okay to have short maps from like 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20, I don't know. It's okay to have this. If this is good, this is good. Longer map, greater map in terms of size, rooms and stuff, is the risk that the rhythm won't be mastered as it would have been if you do short things and little things first. Okay, I thought the statue would
a telling blow
cover us, but this is not the case at all. So we will move here because I'm afraid of a lightning. Okay, what can we do now? Oh, we have yes, we will need to use this because our cleric is dying. Here is for you, mate. Stop sleeping. Okay, not bad. Please, finish him. Mortal Kombat style, you can cut the head off and do whatever you want with it. But please finish it.
Again, harder.
Voilà. Oh nice. I didn't expect that he succeed in this. This action, but it's okay.
Crush him.
Oof. Well. Well, well, well. Okay, so I will take everything because now I think we are done, and then the party will go to the market in order to sell everything and stuff. Oof. Well, let's go. I will check in the DM if we have a final knowledge, because when you play a single map, if a knowledge is written on the exit activator, then you will have this screen and not the knowledge screen. So this is a bug known. Well, this is not a bug, but this is an issue known by Tactical Adventure. I don't know if they will change this. I hope so. But for now, I will just go in the DM and read the final text if there is, and then not the map of video. So in the end, I like this map, but I like the mapping. I didn't really, I was totally lost in the story and stuff. It was rhythm break and stuff. It was not very enjoyable to play, even though it would have been with some things done, not great things, but things that if you do the mistake, then it's a game breaker. Okay, but this is a quick things to fix, and to this map can be very good for small things to change, but for now this is. Well, at least for me, if you like this map very much and stuff, it's okay, totally understandable. So I will just upgrade the guys. Thank you very much for following this review. Thank you, Koperik, for your time and your creativity. I understand that there is a lot of good things, a lot of good ideas, but now this is the time to improve the making of the good ideas. This is my ending world. See you soon for a next map.